Okay, so, and I didn't have my Bible, so I borrowed a stranger's Bible. And I opened it. I opened, right when I opened it, the first thing fell out was his card. I'm like, oh, it's so bright. Who can miss a bright orange card like this? So I picked it up and it reads, for the person. I'm a person. Believing that true love awaits, I make a commitment to God, myself, my family, my friends, my future mate, and my future children to be sexually abstinent from this day until the day I enter a biblical marriage relationship, sign and date. I looked at this card like it was like a plague. I was like, no! God, I was like, are you serious? After 1 month or so praying, God, do you really not want me to have sex? God's like, yes, I don't want you to have sex. Look, it says right here. Don't have sex. Don't. Just don't. Like, why? I didn't understand that. Why? I didn't. But God will teach me as I start trusting Him, taking that first step and saying, okay, God, I don't know. And it's okay to not know. But by faith, I trust you, and I'll take that first step. So then I took that as a sign. I said, 1 year, God, no sex. 1 year, no sex. 1 year. You're going to be classic. That's a long time. But I said, okay, so 1 year, no sex. And in that year, that was in 2008 when I made that vow. Everybody said 2008 was one of the worst years. The economy crashed. You know, wars and all that stuff, and but people, 2008 was the best year of my life so far. He just started showing me things, like by trusting him with that first step of saying, I don't know, you know, he will. He will be there to help you guide the next step, like me right here, and then his hand will come down. So whereas, you know, I mean, it wasn't like, all of a sudden, there's no girls. I'm famous. We don't like you. No, it wasn't like that. It was like more women than I've ever even imagined. And it was crazy because I opened up a nightclub with some friends right when I made that vow. And there were women coming, and women that I was meeting, but in my heart, I made that promise to God. I said, God, I promise I won't have sex. Please, help me, help me, help, help me, help me. And He did. Every time that I see a girl like that was really, you know, pretty smoking girl, I'm like, wow, God! Thank you for creating such a happy-looking pretty girl. Amen. That's all I did, and I walked away with that. And I'm telling you, that was not easy. Because there were so many more. It was a lot, but through that, just by making that first effort, I started seeing women differently. As before, when I didn't, you know, I saw them cool for what they are. They're smart, intelligent, beautiful, strong, independent, loving, caring, needy, beautiful woman. But that wasn't enough. I need to learn how to treat them like strong, beautiful, intellectual, independent women. God started doing that in my life, and that wasn't easy at all either. But, you know, it's now to the point, a year fast forward later, I'm in front of little kids, and about as big as this crowd, sharing them my testimony, saying, why God is better than sex. Why it is important to keep our purity. A lot of times we think that, you know, oh, we're protecting our purity, you know. But that protecting our purity is like, oh no, but in reality our purity is protecting us. It's protecting our hearts, not corrupting it or perversing it through what the world and through what other things are telling us of what it's about. What it means to truly love one person so intimately, to love that one person with all your heart, unconditionally, like how God loves. And through that we learn so much. We learn how to love one person. Like, you know, you created from a ribs, right? So that person completes us. You know. So that's still my ongoing process right now. I'm still learning a lot. And I'm very grateful and thankful for that, because it's been an amazing journey. 2 years, a year passed more later, like I said, standing in front of all these little kids, they gave me the courage to actually sign that card. And that card, and I said, you know what? God, I don't want to go back. This is so real. This is so tangible that this is so much better than anything I've ever experienced. Through partying, through fame, through money. God, I don't want anything else. So, by trusting God with that one small step, I said, you know what, God, I'm just going to make a decision. I'm just going to sign that thing. So I signed it. And then, no sex until I get married. And 2 years ago, I was like, that's so weird. People are clapping me to not have sex. But now it's like, oh. I'm sorry. But no, I mean, that's kind of what I just want to share with you guys, that God can do anything. He will know what it is about your life, because He wrote your life. He knows your story. He knows what's going on. He knows the heartache. He knows the pain. And He knows how to take you out of that if you will just trust Him. If you will just trust Him. You know, yeah, I mean, at first death, you know, I was really lost. I was broken. Sometimes I still feel lost, and sometimes I still feel broken. But I realize no matter how lost I feel, God knows exactly where I am. And He knows exactly where you guys are too. So, you know, with that said, and I'm not saying that, you know, I'm perfect or anything, but with that one small trust in God, saying, you know, God, I'm just entrusted with this part of my life that you showed me was just something I needed to handle and work on. Once I got a hold of that, He started changing other things in my life too, for the better. It wasn't like, oh, VanNess, I believe in you, God, okay, you're free, you're all that wings and all that stuff. No, there was no wings. Not yet. Still not yet. But, through just that, He started showing me, like, hey, you know, VanNess, maybe you don't need to drink so much alcohol all the time. Maybe you don't need to go out and party so late all the time. Maybe you can start caring for other people more. Start making a difference instead of living. I'm like, okay, maybe I do. So every day now in my life has been a journey. And it feels so great to know something in my life that is going to be great will happen. That's the promise that God gives me. He's going to give us all our desires. Right here, and I'm hurt. What is that? Psalms 37:4. Delight yourself in the Lord, He will give you all your heart's desires. I hold that one. God! I want this. But no, seriously. God knows. He never knows. So I thank you guys again for just letting me talk, share with them my heart. And I hope that... Are there any young kids out here tonight? Are there any young kids out here tonight? Oh, I saw that hand go up right there, real quick. Anybody else? See, now where were you at the beginning of the song? The first song I sang, I'm like, come on, put the hands up. You're like,
I don't really know.
Anybody else? Okay, no wonder. You know, but okay, but this message is not only for you young kids out there. It's just for everybody, period. It's just for everybody. God can change you. God can change you. And we are all pure. In His eyes. How we look at it, that's the most important thing. So with that said, I would like to close with a personal song. I don't know if you guys heard it before, but